Hey, Jeff Love here from Alternative Heating and Supplies again with another video to talk about battery backup systems for pellet stoves. This one I'm kind of excited about because I think this is really important and I think this is something that's missing the market that needs to be addressed. Basically, when electricity goes out and you don't have some kind of a battery backup system or something to prevent the stove from turning off, the house can fill up with smoke and other issues. When the power goes out, your furnace goes out, and the pellet stoves are usually what people want to use to heat the house while you are having a power outage. So this product has been out for a while, but I bought the rights to manufacture it, and I want to market it better because I think it's a big issue. It is called the Surefire 512, identified up here. It is the exact same product as the Harman 512, or otherwise known as the 512H. It's exactly identical. It is designed to work with the Harman stoves, but works with many other manufacturers as well. It is a sine wave based product, so it works with most pellet stoves. It can work up with units up to 550 watts. Now, when it comes to a power outage, there's three big problems that exist. One, the auger that feeds the pellets into the stove obviously turns off, which is a computer that tells it how much to add. So that's why you need the sine wave. Two, the combustion fan that blows air onto the can or the burning area where the pellets are burning, blows air on it so they burn nice and hot, as well as it to help to exhaust the pellet stove through a 3-inch flue out the back. The unit will fill up with smoke because there's still material in there burning. And it's not exhausting, so it builds up in the pellet stove, which will eventually exhaust into your own house. That's why, and you'll probably read this in your owner's manuals, is this why most companies do not recommend these stoves inside a bedroom? Because if it does happen, it can cause pretty serious problems, maybe death, smoke ingestion there. And thirdly, now you have no heat. And when the power's out, obviously you need some heat source in the winter. Making your own battery backup. Now, this was kind of entertaining to me because I've seen some people online and other YouTube videos who say, hey, you can make your own battery backup for half the price or even a third of the price. I find this pretty funny because I'll just go over them with you real quick. Making your own battery backup. First of all, you need to find a sine wave inverter, and you can buy them online anywhere from $125 to $250, maybe more, dollars. That can handle that kind of wattage. Problem is that these inverters were not designed to run motors. They were designed to run electronics. When you're trying to turn a motor on, the motors use such a huge burst of energy to get that motor turning or spinning or working that most of these electronic inverters that you buy online for a couple hundred dollars will actually pop a fuse or trip a switch in it, which will make it not work. Two, when the power goes out, you have to get your inverter, get your battery, hook it all up, plug it into the back of your pellet stove, and by that time, if you're sitting there waiting for the power to go out, you might be okay. If not, if you're not at home, or you're sleeping or something else, your house is gonna fill up with smoke anyways. When the power returns, you've got to be, if you're home again, the power returns, your battery will die if you're not home. That means your pellet stove went off again, which is generating more smoke into your building. So when the power does return, you have to break down that inverter, take off the battery, replug in your stove, and do this in a very short amount of time or your house will fill up with smoke yet again. If you're not home and the battery runs out of power before you get back to plug it back in, you fill up your house yet again with smoke. Then, when the power, you take the inverter off and the battery off and everything else, and you plug your stove back on when the power returns, then you've got to take your battery and charge it somehow. Now, I don't know about you, but the way the Surefire works, it is such a simple concept. You take it, you plug it into the wall. You take your stove, plug it into the back of the unit. Take your cables that hook to the battery and you put it to the battery and you leave it there. That is it. When the power goes out, it automatically switches over to battery power. when the battery, when the power from the grid turns back on, it immediately goes back to the power from the grid and starts recharging your batteries. So you're ready for the next episode if it happens again. You can also put these batteries into series. That means you can have 3, 4, 5, or 6 batteries involved here if you'd like, for the longer runs if you'd like. Now, I get a lot of questions is how long does my unit run on a battery? That depends on the unit and also the quality of the battery. What I do recommend, and I would tell everybody, that the average is about 8 to 12 hours, but get your inverter, put a battery on, unplug your system from the wall, and try it. And if you're getting 6 hours or 7 hours and you want longer, get another battery, put it in series, charge it back up, and go again. That's the best way that I think that you can find out the way to find out how long, and you'll sleep well at night knowing what is capable of doing. So this is highly recommended for all pellet stoves, especially the Harmans, and this was originally designed for the Harmans and other stoves. So check it out, see if it helps, and there's other videos online, and even Harman still has videos online that are still recommending this actual very device. I hope you found this video educational and interesting, and we appreciate it. You guys have a great day, and thank you for watching our channel. Please subscribe, and we'll be putting these videos up periodically to keep you up to date on more of this interesting stuff. Have a great day.